حبيبي سيدي السلام عليك يا نبي العالمين.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. All the praise and all the glory is due to Allah. And I bear witness that there is no God but Allah, and that Muhammad is his last prophet and messenger. May the blessings and peace of Allah be upon our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his family, his companions, and those who followed his path up to the day of judgment. My dear respected brothers and sisters, I'm speaking to you very close to the Haram, the Masjid of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the mosque in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the Quranic verses, which says la masjidun usisa ala taqwa min awwal yawmin ahaqqu an takuma fi. A masjid or a mosque which has been established on taqwa, on piety and fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a place that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has established and built in Medina at the first time when he entered that blessed city. The Medina of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has a lot of merits and a lot of great rewards for people who live in it. On the top of that, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam promised people who die in Medina to receive his great shafa'a, intercession on the day of judgment. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the authentic hadith that whoever dies in Medina, I will be his intercessor on the day of judgment. He also said to a group of the Bedouins who came to Medina, but they suffered from the cold weather and also from the difficulties of staying in it, telling them they wanted actually to leave the place. So the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to them, وَالْمَدِينَةُ خَيْرٌ لَهُمْ لَوْ كَانُوا يَعْلَمُونَ. Medina is better for them if they know. So the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used actually to love every single inch on that place. When he traveled in any battle or in any trip, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to go quickly to Medina to return back, and he used to knock on the walls of its dwellings by saying, this is Taba, this is Taiba, it is a pure place. And the word Taba or Taiba is derived from the Arabic word Taba, which means pure and clean. So the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also said, إِنَّ الْإِيمَانَ لَيَأْرِزُ إِلَى الْمَدِينَةِ كَمَا تَأْرِزُ الْحَيَّةُ إِلَى جُحْرِهَا. Iman refers and takes rescue in Medina exactly like a snake takes protection in its hole. So at the end of the time, when the whole earth is spread of corruption, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will save the iman of the people of Medina. It will be intact according to the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Also, it is the dwellings of the Ansar, the people who gave protection to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَالَّذِينَ تَبَوَّأُوا الدَّارَ وَالْإِيمَانَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ يُحِبُّونَ مَنْ هَاجَرَ إِلَيْهِمْ وَلَا يَجِدُونَ فِي صُدُورِهِمْ حَاجَةً مِمَّا أُوتُوا وَيُؤْثِرُونَ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ وَلَوْ كَانَ بِهِمْ خَصَاصَةً. Those who established themselves firmly in Iman, receiving the early immigrants, and they prefer them to themselves. These are the places of those great people and that amazing generation who lived with the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Even the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam has a very serious hadith that whoever wants or cares or seeks after harming the people of Medina, Allah will make him being melted. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make him melted like salt being melted in water. This is a very glad tidings to the people living in that place. Here you can find in every single inch, in every single place where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam lived, stepped his feet, spoke a word. In those places, the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to walk. In those places, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to eat, or used to drink, or used to visit the Sahaba. You can see the Sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam like a table in front, like a book in front of you, where you can read spots. It also records the sufferings of the Sahaba and the sufferings of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When Bilal and Abu Bakr first migrated to Medina, they had a difficulty because Medina was actually a contaminated area and it included fever. So whoever stays in Medina at the beginning used to suffer from fever. So Abu Bakr used to go to the mountain, remembering the good memories of living in Mecca, where they used to live at their homes, among their people and their fellows. And immediately now they are alone and they suffer from a lot of diseases. So the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam made dua to the people of Medina by saying, Allahumma habibna fil madinati wa habib al madinata fina. O Allah, increase our love to Medina and make our love to it similar to our love to Mecca, where they used to live. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam made dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala removes the fever from his city and to make it blessed for him. There is another report in which the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam made supplications for the people of Medina and for everything included in it. So the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, O Allah, bless our sa', and sa' is the measurement that the people of Medina used to have in measuring the grains and their food. So everything included in that city is blessed, including food, drink, air, life, and knowledge. And it became the center of knowledge since the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So we had the report when one of the companions entered the masjid of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he said, I found the companions of Muhammad like oceans giving water everywhere. One of them narrating a hadith to another, a man narrating to two, and a man narrating to three, and a man narrating, if he narrates or transmits a hadith for the whole world, it would suffice them. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it very blessed. And it is sufficient to say that it has the grave of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Messenger preferred to be buried in Medina. And we remember the authentic hadith, which is some of the Sahaba, when they moved to Mecca for the conquest or for the opening of Mecca, and some of them wanted to stay for a longer period with their families. So the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam commanded them to end up Hajj quickly and return back to Medina. And he said, Allahumma amdiri ashabi hijratahum. Oh Allah, fulfill the reward of my companions of making migration in your cause. And he prohibited them to stay in Mecca even after becoming a city for Islam. I still also remember when I go in the corners of this place, the hadith of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, which he declared Medina as a sacred place or as inviolable place. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, according to the authentic hadith, that Ibrahim declared Mecca to be inviolable, where trees are not supposed to be cut, birds to be killed, or animals to be murdered, or anything. It's sacred, it's protected, it's saved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the same rule applies to Medina. From the two mountains surrounding Medina, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam declared it to be an inviolable place. So it has the same rights and duties like Mecca. And it is also sufficient of the merits of Medina that this is the only city along with Mecca that the Antichrist will not be able to enter. We know one of the major signs of the Day of Judgment that the Antichrist will spread corruption on the earth. And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that the only two cities that will not be attacked by the Antichrist or Al-Masih al-Dajjal is Mecca and Al-Medina, because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam confirmed that angels are standing on its mountains and hills protecting the city against anything coming or approaching it. Also within Medina, a lot of events happened, and it was a center of illumination. In those places, my brothers and sisters, Jibreel came. The Quran was revealed. Angels go every second. According to the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, whoever sent salam to the Prophet, Allah caused his soul to return back, and he sends an angel having the salam to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So it is a place which is full of spirituality, a place which is full of blessings. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for my respected viewers and listeners, inshallah, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sincerely to provide us a long stay and death in the Medina of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa salli allahumma ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.
Every breath I take, every beating of my heart, in word and silence, let there be peace upon you, O fountain of perfection, O ocean. Longer shall we be apart. As-salam.